This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video.
Hey Janik, I learned this new superpower. Wanna see it?
Sure, show me. Still don't believe you.
Okay, watch closely.
Still not convinced, Lorenzo.
Okay, one last demo. Check this out.
Guys, I'm telling you, Jill is getting weirder and weirder every week. What's next? Coming to work dressed as Stitch? Okay, that just really happened. But if you want to know some other weird stuff about Jill, just ask away in the comments. He will gladly answer them for you. Okay, let's start with Copycat Friday. This week we are going back down memory lane and are recreating an older effect. The effect that I'm talking about is walking through the walls, which is a superpower from X-Men's Shadowcat. Meow. In X-Men 3 The Last Stand, we can see her running through the walls while being chased by the Juggernaut, which is apparently the stepbrother of Professor Xavier. Who knew? But that aside, the effect is quite cool and also not that hard to make. Of course, it depends on how you do it, because if you try to do it practically, it can go wrong. Whoa, that looks painful, but great save. So to achieve this effect, you're going to need Premiere Pro and two tripod shots. An empty shot of the wall you're walking in or out from, and the second shot will be a green screen shot. Here you need to position the camera in the same angle as your first shot. Place the green screen in such a way that your actor will be completely surrounded by the green. Also keep in mind that your actor needs to move, so make the green screen big enough. Now for the actor, let him move and stand in the same angle as your wall in the previous shot. So if you would overlay the two shots, the actor would be parallel with the wall. Okay, that is it for the shots. Let's start with the post-production. But first, let's see what Jordi has to say.
Just use a door, Jordi.
Ah, man. But I want to walk through walls and doors as well, Lorenzo, just like you.
Well, only I can do it.
Well, you know what you don't have, Lorenzo, and what I do? A subscription to Storyblocks Video! That's right, because with Storyblocks Video, I can just browse through hundreds of After Effects templates where I can simply change my own brand name in and render it out. It's that simple. And besides the amazing After Effects templates, you can also find 4K stock clips. There are green screen clips on there, which you can use in your commercial projects. There are tons of effects like smoke and sparks and overlay effects and so much more. And the amazing thing is that there's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets. So Lorenzo, make sure to click the first link in the description below to get your own Storyblocks subscription and be as cool as me. Oh yeah, folks at home, also click that first link. It's really cool. Go check it out. I don't need to walk through walls. I'm just gonna use a door and use my Storyblocks subscription. Ha!
Open up your Premiere Pro and start with dragging your empty wall clip to the first video track. The next step is to drag your green screen clip to the third track. And once in place, you can look for the Ultra Key effect in the effects library and drag that to your green screen clip. Now within the effects controls, take your color picker and select the green color. This will already remove the green, but if needed, you can always adjust the matte generation settings until you have a clean key. If this went a little bit too fast, we have a very detailed green screen tutorial. So if you want to check that out, you can find the link to that video in the description below. Now after your key, you also need to mask out the rest of the clip, so your actor is the only thing left on the green screen clip. Okay, you already have your actor placed in the empty shot. Now let's do the rest of the effect. The first thing you can do now is nest the actor's clip. We do this because we are going to work with multiple masks and that's not Premiere's strongest point. So after you nested the clip, let's create a mask. You can leave it quite rough, but it needs to be around a small portion of your actor's hand. Just make the mask rounded where it cuts into the arm. Now enable the animation for the mask pad and over time open it up, so your body slowly reveals itself through the wall. Try to keep the mask rounded where you cut off the body, because a human body has zero straight lines. Everything is rounded. Now that you have your first mask that opens up and reveals your actor, let's add a few more. This time create a mask around the actor's face and start quite small. For example, only his nose. Then again open up the mask over time, and once the two masks start overlapping, you can stop animating this mask as our first mask will take over. Now do this one more time, create a mask around the actor's knee and go further in time to open up the mask. Again stop animating the mask once they overlap. This will already leave you with your actor going through the wall. However, we still need to add the shadow and the wall distortion. But first, I want to do a short break with a Janik fun fact fountain. Do you know why walking through walls is quite impossible? Well, it's a violation of one of the basic laws in physics. Two things can never share the same space. Sounds quite obvious, but it goes a lot deeper in theory. Don't worry, I'm not gonna bore you with the science stuff. What I do wanna say is the fact that Shadowcat, or Kitty Pryde, is named after a real person. The creator of Shadowcat once met a girl in art class named Katie Pryde, and liked her name so much he used it when creating Shadowcat. How cool is that? Imagine, Janik Turnison, hero of the universe, slayer of evil. I like that. But enough yapping, let's continue with the effect. The next step is to create a shadow on the wall. First, create a color mat in the project panel, make it black and drag it in between the actor's clip and the wall clip. You can already set the opacity to around 60%. Now make a mask on the black color mat on the same position where your hand goes through the wall. Create it so that the shadow is only visible on one side of the hand. Then maintain the same principle as before and over time open up your mask. But keep the shadow on one side of your actor. Do this two more times so that the other incoming parts of the actor also have a shadow. Now for the feather of these three masks, we are going to start around 110. Enable the animation for the mask feather and over time animate them to around 400. The last detail is the distortion on the wall itself. Look for the turbulent displays effect in the effects library and drag it to the wall clip. Now again create a mask within the turbulent displays effect and let it start around the actor's hand and over time let it open up. The last thing you can do now is animate the amount of the turbulent displays effect. This can start from 0 right before the hand comes in and will go to 200 on the point where your actor is almost through the wall. Of course, go back to 0 when your actor is completely through. And that is it for the effects. If you want, you can always add a fake handheld motion to it, but it's not necessary. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Also, let us know in the comments below what we can create for next Copycat Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Like, subscribe, and as always... stay creative. It's like this is going up.
20!